In PLC programming systems, every kind of PLC, you must be know what is the input-output addressing system and how to recognize of any kinds of PLC hardware, input-output module, or shortly I/O module. This is the structure of a PLC. Specifically, we are introduce what is the and how you are recognize of any kinds of PLC, which is an input module for digital input and digital output, or analog input, analog output. Every kind of devices, specifically, there are built in any kinds of PLC, every kind of slot that introduces like as analog input output, or individually analog input or analog output, digital input and digital output. This is the systematic rules. And this is the hardware structure or hardware building structure of any kinds of PLC system. This is the S7-1500 PLC brand of Siemens, Siemens S7-1500 PLC. So this is the hardware configuration or hardware slot system, or shortly we are called that I/O modules. So these hardware systems, this is only the CPU. We call this is the CPU, and this is the analog input and output module. For individually, there are built-in addressing system in hardware functions by software. So how do we write a programming sequence? Then before we contact to this hardware configuration of S7-1500 by TU portal. If you are a familiar of S7-1500 PLC software or S7-1200, software, there is a two is similar. So the times when we are doing the hardware configuration system, the times we are included the input output addressing system also, and that's called the tag system. For my previous video, that was the I given the 7-1200 PLC. I hope you got some knowledge about the hardware configuration system of the TF portal in S7-1200 PLC. So friends, this is the digital input and digital output module. So specifically, we are introduce how to recognize and how you connect of every devices in any kinds of hardware system, that is called PLC hardware configuration system, software and hardware also the system. Let's get into the video.
Dear friends, if you like video of Planet Automation Limited, please subscribe the channel and then click the bell icon. This process will never miss another new update.
So friends, firstly we have to describe about the topics of analog input. How do you recognize analog input devices in any kinds of PLC system? Connected to the any kinds of temperature sensor. This is the hot chamber, and just like this is the temperature sensor RTD. RTD is a temperature sensor which detects the temperature, and its output going to the electrical signal. Its input is temperature, and that's converted by transducer electrical signal RTD, which is detected the temperature. So now this is the signal towards current. So now initially we are detecting this suppose this is the 100 degree temperature in hot chamber. Increasing the temperature, the times its electrical signal is going to this higher, and increasing the temperature is very slowly, 100 to 140 degrees Celsius, you are seeing here. So this systematically we are consuming the temperature by hot chamber to analog input and detecting our temperature this systematic way. So this is the way of analog input, and this is the RTD module must be need in here. So friends, this is the analog input we are called this RTD of any kinds of pressure transmitter. It's all kinds of devices which is continuously changing the value. The times we are called this is the analog input devices. So analog input devices is not a fixed value. It's changing the values every times abruptly. So this is very important, because when your temperature is increasing, not a fixed device, it's not by increasing the temperature. So it is actually dependent on our hot chamber. When hot chamber temperature is increasing, that means this temperature will be increasing, and that display will be shown there. So this is the processing for analog input. So this is the controlling system for analog input. And now we are going to this output. How to display of your pressure or your temperature? It's just like this. Suppose this is the pressure transmitter, which is receiving the pressure by suction line. So now we are detecting this temperature is also the 420 milliampere or due to 10 volt. This is the all is our analog input generating ampere, milliamps voltage for generating amperes or due to 10 volt. For due to 10 volts the pressure transmitter, we are also detecting the this is generating voltage in any kinds of pressure transmitter or pressure flow meter, any kinds of devices. This is our flow section rate or generating voltage. It is increasing very smoothly. So 420 milliamps, this is our pressure range. Minimum pressure detecting this is 4 is our minimum value, and our maximum value approach, that is 20 milliamps. This is our ranging value, and that is fixed. And our minimum and maximum pressure, that is not a fixed, that is a vary of any kinds of load when we are detecting or a test, and that is our industrial demand. So friends, this is our pressure transmitter, which is display the pressure value V in PSI mode. So this is our pressure unit. Okay, this is our pressure unit, which is display the pressure. So this is the analog output, which is display our pressure. This is called the digital output, and this is called the pressure input. That means this is not a fixed at all time. This is a vary every seconds, every milliseconds. This pressure will vary, and our temperature will vary. So will find any kinds of pressure, temperature, any kinds of flow will changing every seconds, every milliseconds. That's called the analog input, which is not fixed. So the times or that function we called the analog input. Okay, so friends, this is the analog input. You are specifically know the pressure transmitter, any kinds of RTD, thermocouple, which is detecting the temperature, any kinds of flow meter, which is counting the flow, how much flow in PSI mode or PSU mode, or whatever. So this is called the analog input, which is not fixed. Next, go to this digital input in here. So digital input is all times it's defined. It's a very easy topics. Previously we called about the analog input and output, and now we called about the digital input. The very easy topics in here. We all time familiar of this digital input. Analog input and output, this is a very critical function, but digital input is a starting choice, stop choice, so reset button. It's called emergency button. It's called the digital, which is very 0 or 1. Okay, not very every times when you are start of any kinds of load, the times you start switch, push this switch is in here. When you want to start up your load, the times you push this button. And when you are reset of any kinds of alarm systems, you know, individual functions or any kinds of machine, your running machine, when you are show the any kinds of alarm, that times you are push this reset button. And when any kinds of emergency occurrence or any kinds of emergency situations you are faced, the times you going, we are going to this emergency stop button. So this is the digital input, which is vary for 0 and 1, that means high and low, on and off, the times we are called the digital input. Okay, so friends, understand, very easy to understand, when we are on and off any kinds of load, the times is called the digital input. We are connect of our systematic input sensor or any kinds of switch, such as a push button, select switch, toggle switch, any kinds of switch we are uses. The times is called the digital input. which is 011, that is on and off style working in kinds of field. So that is called the digital input. Okay, now introducing to the digital output, very important, that's also dependent on the digital input, and this is a start button and it's a stop button, and this is connected, it is as like as a digital or digital output, which is on and off start wheel, or just we are display in here, which is a rotating cells on and off style. I want to describe this on when start, when start the our load, the times it's going to start, when stop, that's going to stop, and also that a logic is in here. So friends, when we are attached another load in our devices, such as any kinds of valve or any kinds of indicator, so that times we are attached to this another load in PLC systems. So this is the controlling systems of our digital input, digital output with our programming sequence for internal hardware of any kinds of PLC. We are doing in this PLC as like as this data logic and physically connect up our this digital input, and this is called the digital output. Physically work. All is compressed working systems in industrial automation system. So specifically, we are now about to know very important, which is digital input. Digital input is called the this digital switch off, on, reset, emergency stopped, whatever. And this is called the digital output, which is anytime you want to stop, start, anything is possible in these situations. So friends, this is the calling system of industrial automation, and this is the input output IO. You have any confusion about the topics of analog input and output, and which is digital input and output, which is analog input and output in PLC hardware system or hardware configuration system, and of course when you are going to connect of your PLC, the times you will not hazard of your physical connectivity for these PLC systems. Our next video tutorials about the programs in PLC for analog sequence. So friends, for the Abacus video of Fluent Automation Limited, and subscribe the channel and click the bell icon. Waiting for the next video tutorial, season all of us.